I just wanted to put my 2 cents out there, whatever that's worth, about the LNS Technologies Model 150 that I have here. People talk about that on this forum. I appreciate this forum. I've never, that's why I joined it, to learn what I can. A lot of people say the Model 150 is not worth the price. And I wanted to tell everybody, explain why I think it was. I bought the 150 at a time that I was making my product here. This is my pigtail wedge. This is a tool that I've invented for truck drivers that stops flickering trailer lights. And at the time, when I first started selling these, I was making them on a 3D printer, and I was having them made by different people because I have no interest in a 3D printer. So it came to the time that the quality I was getting from 3D printing was not good enough for what I wanted this product to be. So I started looking into injection molding. Well, as everybody knows, it can get quite pricey with injection molding, between having the mold made and then having someone else make the part for you. And the cost of the part itself was not a problem, but the upfront cost of the injection molding, as far as I could find quickly, was just too high. And so I started looking into these benchtop presses like this, because I wanted to get a product that was injection molded, but I didn't want to go through the cost of, $10,000, $12,000, $15,000 to have the mold made, and then $1.50 to $2 a piece, in America at least, to have the parts made, and a minimum order of 5,000 pieces. And I'm sure there are other companies out there, smaller companies, and if I'd have known about this forum at the time, I probably would have done a little better research and found somebody to do this for me. But I needed something quick, was turnkey, and did not have a very high learning curve, because I needed it now. And instead of going through all of the different ways of making your own and building this and building that and figuring out how to put it all together and make it work, I did this research, and this was the best option for me. And yeah, it was pricey. It's $1,800 for this machine. But when I'm running a small business, the investment was worth it, because I got the machine in, I think, 2 or 3 days, and had it set up, and it couldn't have been 10 minutes, 20 minutes at the most, to set up the machine and bolt it down to my tabletop here, to my bench. And the learning curve to make it work was very quick. And as you can see, I can pump out a part now with this machine every 30 to 40 seconds. And it is manual, and I understand that. That's fine with me for now. I sell these tools, 50, 100 pieces at a time, a week. So the fact that it doesn't make thousands and thousands at a time, I don't need that. I don't need a Boy or a Morgan Press or any other kind of a big facility kind of a thing. Now, at some point, I hope, as I sell my invention, that I will come to the point that I will either have to upgrade to something more efficient, or contract the service out to someone to do it for me. But this is the reason that I bought the Model 150 from LNS, because it was turnkey and it was ready to go so quickly, and I had no loss of revenue, and it's well made back the money that I've spent for it. The $1,800, I mean, that was not a huge investment to me as I'm moving along right now. And now that it's paid for, my all the equipment I have to make this, because I put a lanyard on it too. I have a hot knife that I cut to paracord. It was worth it to me. So I just wanted to put this out there to let anybody know that is like me and looking to upgrade from a 3D printer and want to get started in injection molding, you can start with a press. And if you don't want to go through the trouble of learning how to build one, set it up, get everything working right, get all the parameters set. You want something turnkey? All you got to do is pull it out of the box, plug it in, ready to go. I absolutely love the LNS Technologies Model 150A. It makes all of my parts just the way I need. It works with anything from polypropylene to ABS. And this is a TPV with polypropylene mix. It's a 66% TPV and 33% polypropylene to give me the mix that I want. Now, it is a vertical machine, so it doesn't mix it as best as it possibly can because it doesn't have the screw auger. But this works for what I need. This works perfectly. Gives me the flexibility that I need. I need it flexible like that so it doesn't break for the use that I have. So this machine is absolutely perfect for my needs. And I just wanted to put that out there to let everybody know why I would spend the $1,800 for such a machine.